Hey everybody, and welcome to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. This is going to be my very first game comment video on YouTube. It's going to be featuring my very favorite RPG of all times, which is Xanadu. And yeah, I think it's really one of the most interesting early 8-bit RPG games there is. It was really, really popular in Japan when it was first released in 85 for the PC-88. And it's still popular with me, so yeah, let's get this started. Now in Xanadu, the first thing you need to do, it's a side-scrolling RPG by the way, so you can move from left to right and you can jump a little bit, but mostly left to right. First thing you want to do is visit the king, because the king will give you your starting equipment and send you on your way. So let's do that by standing in front of this door and pressing the space bar to go in. Now the king, the first thing he wants to know is our name, which is going to be Roas. The king will supply us with a dagger, a needle spell, a cloth armor, gloves, and spectacles to start with. Because really, what hero doesn't need a good set of glasses? And yeah, the first thing we need to do after visiting the king is going to all these little houses and getting our initial stat points distributed. As you can see, they're all marked with different stats, strength, intelligence, etc. And you need to find a good distribution. I'm not going to go into really great detail because that's going to take forever. I'll actually put a little link in the description down below so you guys can read like what the different stats do and what a good distribution is and the effects the different skills have. I'll explain really quickly what they do. First of all, strength obviously is your melee attack, so if you have a high strength, your dagger will do more damage. If you have high int, your spells will do more damage. You know, the basics. So yeah, let's get a bunch of strength points. You get 30 points to start with, so you can distribute them any way you want. Personally, I feel like your strength and your intelligence need to be between 50 and 100 to be competitive, because if they're much lower than 50, you won't be able to kill monsters nearly fast enough. You'll be okay in the first level, but after that it'll go downhill really quickly. Now next is wisdom. I tend to take only 1 point in wisdom because wisdom is for using items and I don't favor using items too much. Next is dexterity. Now dexterity I will get four points in because dexterity is used for opening treasure boxes, and if you have low dexterity it takes forever and you don't want that. Next is agility. Now your agility is, it basically determines how fast monsters move when you fight them. So if you have high agility, monsters will move slowly, so you'll be able to outflank them more easily, you'll be able to avoid damage more easily. So you want to get a couple of points in there, but it's not the most important thing in the world. And then we have charisma, and charisma obviously is the most important thing in the world. I mean, just look at this training character and you'll immediately see why charisma is more important than some naked wrestling guy or God only knows who this is. So yeah, let's just spend the rest of our 10 points on charisma. Seriously, for a second, the reason I like to get a lot of charisma is because it makes buying items much, much, much cheaper, and it'll help you get your equipment up to date more quickly, and equipment is really important in this game. The last skill we could have bought is magic resistance, but I've already spent all my points, so ta-ta to you. Now after you buy all your skills, you can go down this ladder to get to the actual dungeon. As you can see, you'll start falling down this big hole, and then we need to find the entrance to the actual area where we can start playing the game. First thing you need to do is find it, and there's actually a little trick to it, at least to do it quickly. Which is to, as soon as you get to the bottom of this shaft, you move to the left 5 steps, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then move back. As you can see, we'll get teleported to the item store. I'll just show you the inside really quickly. The item store sells all the regular items you can use outside of your weapons and armor and that sort of thing. There's quite a lot of them. Again, I'll put a little link in the description area of this video so you can see what all the items do. And yeah, because it's way too much to explain right now. If you want to leave a store without buying anything, just press enter without entering any keys. Now, after we've visited this store, you can see there's a little ladder down here now, which leads to the actual cave entrance. You can find it by running around in all the caves upstairs, but it's easier to get there this way. And as soon as we get to the end of this cave, we'll find the entrance. Here we go. As soon as you go into this entrance, by pressing the spacebar again, we'll see about some actual gameplay. So we've left the starting town area. Let me just pause it really quickly. And this is the actual first level of the actual dungeon. Once you get in here, your food will start going down, monsters will be roaming around, so you might get attacked. This is where the actual gameplay starts. First thing you really want to do when you get in is to buy some food, because the 100 food that you start with will run out pretty quickly. Every gold piece buys you 10 food, so I like to start with buying 50 food. That'll give us 50 gold worth of food, which gives you 500, and that'll last us for quite some time. After that, we'll be out of here. As you see, right next to it, there's an inn, which is basically the same as a food store, only it sells you hit points instead of food. We don't need it right now because we haven't actually been damaged yet, but this is where you one of the places you can recharge your health. And then, yeah, see, as you can see, we can just run around here left to right. These ladders will let us move up and down. And you can see a skeleton and, oops, and some other, like, slimes and other creatures here, snakes. Okay, now to show you some combat. Okay, that's, if we want to fight this snake, all you have to do is just run into it. Just run up against it and it'll start the combat screen. You can see on the right-hand side over there, it'll show the enemy's hit points. There's two ways to attack an enemy. You can either shoot him with your spells by pressing the spacebar again. Here you go. Oops, I ran off screen. You can quit combat by running off screen anytime. So if you wanna, if you're outmatched or you don't want to fight this creature for some reason, all you have to do is move off screen and it'll you'll be back in the proper dungeon itself. Oh yeah, like I was saying. So you can kill creatures in two ways. You can either shoot them with your magic attacks, which I'll do right now. You might have to shoot them a couple of times, and that will kill them. As soon as they die, as you can see, they'll drop a little treasure box, which contains gold, usually. The second way to kill a creature is by using your melee attacks, so your sword or your axe or whatever. You can use this by just walking up to them. So I'm hitting this creature right now by pressing left, and it has basically the same effect. It'll kill the critter. Let me do this one again. There we go. As soon as they're all dead, the music will go back to normal. You can move off screen after you've looted all the boxes, and you can go back to regular gameplay. Now there's another thing to keep in mind when you're fighting enemies, and let me show that with this bat here. As I said, you can either shoot them with your magic, and they'll drop a little bit of gold. Or you can run into them and kill them like this. You can see bats are a little bit stronger than bees, so they'll damage you a little bit when you run into them. But normally, you'll want to, in any group, you'll want to kill the last creature with your sword instead of your magic. And the reason for this is, as you can see, if you kill it with your sword, it'll drop a red box instead of a white one. And red boxes very often contain items instead of gold. And items are almost always more valuable than the gold you would have normally gotten. It's not absolutely always, there are exceptions. But generally speaking, it's a good idea to kill the last creature in a stack with your normal weapon, just so you can get some nice items out of the deal. Ochre jellies are a good example, because as soon as you kill the last one here, let me just see if I can get this one out of the way first. Kill this one with my dagger. This one drops a key when you kill them all, and keys are really valuable in this game. Keys will help you get into places that you normally can't get, and yeah, they're just really, really worthwhile. But in general, I mean, just kill any monster you can with your sword if they're not too terribly overpowering. For example, these fire elements will drop a lamp, I believe, if I kill them all with my sword, or at least the last one. As you can see, my sword is a little bit weak right now, or my dagger, because I haven't really leveled up yet or spent too much on strength. There we go. Now, as you may have noticed, we get experience for every kill we make. Important to remember is that there's two types of experience. You can see them on the right hand side there. There's fighter experience and wizard experience. Every time you kill a monster with your sword, obviously you get fighter experience. Every time you kill a monster with your magic, you get wizard experience. And you actually level up the two separately. So you can level up your fighter to level 5 and your wizard to level 2, or the other way around. Doesn't really matter, but it changes your stat distribution a little bit, the type of hit points you get, that sort of thing. Okay. Now, you may have noticed in the background occasionally you'll see these little castles. You can actually get into these by standing in front of them and pressing the space bar. This will get you into the castle, and inside you'll be able to fight monsters. You'll be able to find special loot that you won't find outside, like this this scroll you see over here. You might be able to find stuff that increases your strength or other stuff, and you'll also be able to find the end of level boss in castles usually. Right now, I won't go into here yet because I don't think I have a lamp. Oh, actually, I do have a lamp, don't I? I got it from the bat. But you know what? This video has been going on long enough. I'll end the video here, and in the next video I'll show you the inside of the castle. So thanks for watching so far, guys. If you have any questions, comments, requests, then please leave them in the comments box down below. And I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thanks very much for watching.